Good afternoon, all of you. I'm very pleased that I've been invited to tell a little bit or to give a kind of a kickoff of the 60 years anniversary of this beautiful institute. And Frits was already explaining that you regularly may see me in the institute, normally one day a week. Now you know what I'm doing there, not lecturing or whatever, but working on the archive, mainly the photo archive of this institute, in collaboration with Laura and with Peter Stroh. Now, 60 years of IHC. I want to use this motto also as a lesson. There's no future without history of an institute. And I'd like to thank Ronald De Heer mainly because much of the information I'm providing you today is in the end coming from his innumerable files he have given to me in the past. Thanks, Ronald. Let's go. What is the reason of existence of this institute? And that's in fact the February storm in 1953 in the Netherlands, which was about 2,000 deadly victims, and that has led in the Netherlands to the so-called Delta Project, and I don't have to explain to somebody what that means. But it had there was a follow-up of that. There was already soon after the start of the Delta Project, there was a request of the ambassador of Pakistan for technical assistance in their fight against flooding in the eastern part of Pakistan. And that took some time, but in the end, and I want to, this is a letter known to many of you, it is in fact a letter 1987 from the Pakistan ambassador in the 50s in the Netherlands as a thank, he is thanking the institutes. But in the end, that resulted in a program in 1957-58. The first course in hydraulic engineering was set up with 44 participants from 21 countries. That was, in fact, the first activity. Now, and I'm very happy that I also have a picture of the first awarding ceremony. This is a picture from 1958. There are 39 participants awarded. Of the other five, I don't know if they left before. I can find that back in the archives, but I don't know yet. If you count the number of participants, there are 38. One was lacking here. And in front of it are all the lectures, including, and now I have to see if I can use. Okay. If you look to the 7th one in the first row from the left, you see the first director of the institute, Professor Mosterdman. And you may see him more. And to the very right is Professor Verhoeven, one of the first professors of this institute. Two old-fashioned and for all, mainly people that made their contribution to this institute. And more peculiarly, it is the second row, the 1, 2, 3, 4th from the right, it is Professor Diklitsch. At that time a student, but he has been a professor in the institute for quite some time. So he came in the first batch. That is the picture of the awarding of 58. Just for fun, I have here another picture of an awarding ceremony, not a ceremony, awarding photograph in front of the former entrance of this institute, Oude Delft 95. When I started here in 1988, that was still the entrance to the institute. We only use it nowadays for if the cortege is leaving the institute to be, if the students are awarded in the church. But that's the only time it's used. And you may see also here, for the older ones, some old staff members, like again him at the back, in the middle, it is again Professor Mosterdman. But you also see Eugène Damen, You see, Adrie Verweij, Pim Grijn, to end Professor Bas Verhoeven again, for some to, if they have good eyes, they may find them. If you want to know, I'll tell you later. The names of the institutes have been changed quite often, well, maybe in 60 years, not that often, but in 57 it was called the International Courses, without any addition. We started in 1964 with the International Courses in Hydraulic and Sanitary Engineering, and from 1976 to 2003 it was called IHE, International Institute for Hydraulic and Environmental Engineering. That's what IHE means, in fact. This is an old sign in the of the front of the institute. And 2003 to 2017, it is UNESCO IHE Institute for Water Education. And you see here the building 10 years ago, exactly 10 years ago, with our festivities of 50 years IHE. And here I have to put question marks. Maybe in 10 years I have also filled this. Some important activities or festivities. The first one is 25 years IHE. Prince Klaus, the father of the present king, was giving his the main speech. In 1991, it was 25 years of hydrology, and I show this picture because it was this year 50 years of hydrology in December. So here the last rector, before Fritz, was Andras, and he was one of the invited speakers on the 25th years of hydrologists. And the last one, you don't see a star or participant, you see a tram. The 40 years we all went to The Hague by tram. The trams were stopping here in front of the institute, three trams, and they were loaded with staff and participants, and we all went by tram to The Hague for some festive activities. Then we had 50 years of IHE. Then we had the main presentation was given by, at that time, Crown Prince Willem-Alexander, now our king, and he is seconded by our rector at that time, Richard Migenk, and by the vice rector, Maarten Blokland, and with two others, with Laura and Peter Stroh and myself, we were allowed to make a booklet about the 50 years of this institute. Some of our main activities, of course, giving regular programs, but also from 1986 onwards, we had our first MSc awardees, and this was in fact the very first MSc awarded. Who is this? Nobody knows. It's Mr. Suwinska from Poland. And Professor Segeren is at that time rector, is giving her the awarding. I don't go through all these MSc awardings, there were quite a lot, but it's always nice to see that some people that are still staff member here did also receive their MSc degree in this institute. Ah, I hear that somebody are recognizing him. Is Bane here? Yeah. Hey Bane, do you recognize yourself? We also had the first PhD, that was in 1994, by Nini Tang in hydroinformatics, were our first PhD students to be awarded. And again, to see that also our own staff is awarded, has done PhD work here. I have here, and you recognize him in the middle? Suryadi, sir? Not you. He was awarded in 1996. This is just, don't go through the details, these were just some old diploma awardings. In the past we didn't have an MSc, we just had diplomas. And this is in fact the some of these diploma awardings. And you may recognize the staff members awarding the diploma for all these. Quite some are present here. in the retired staff, and one is still active in the institute, although it is not too long anymore. Hans van Bruggen, the upper right. I've changed quite a lot indeed. You can't go through a history if you don't show some historical figures. And there's one historical figure you can't deny. It is Professor Wil Segeren. On the right hand side, in the very beginning of the new building we are sitting in now, it was in 1919. And Wil Segeren has made this institute as big as it is now. So, really a historical figure. I have some more, of course, it's a selection. Maurice Ladivere was vice rector for a long period in this institute. He passed away recently in September, on the age of 92. He was very active till in the very late last years of his life. And Toek Roel, our first librarian of Oude Delft 91. And we had a lot of parties at that time. And of course, Segeren is sitting there again. He was always present at the parties, but he did present the beer. That was done by Ruud Slootweg for a very long time. He was our catering head. And some people do recognize Sylvia Verboog standing behind him. But these were great days. With lots of drinks. I also have some historical support. Now, you can't imagine nowadays a planning office without a computer. But this was in 1986. This was the planning. All planning was done on planning boards. Caroline Sidney Klaas still is that? She has done it, probably the last one of the present staff who has done it still in the old-fashioned way. Marijke Waterreus is the planning officer here. And you see behind the planning of boards, you see Bert van Duyl, also a retired staff member. The computer group in 1988, three of them are still working here. Wim Glas, Wim, can't recognize yourself here. And Willem van Lieveld, the right hand side, Wim Glas is the one to the on the left. And the standing on the left and sitting on the left is Roel Normaal. So they are still working here, and it is a picture of 1988. We see Harry Pleurnis, Adrie Verwij, Tony Mintz, and for me, unknown student probably. I haven't found his name yet. And also, always nice to see the laboratory staff, also in 1989 in the lab. Two of them are still working here, the head, Fred, he is not in today, at that time already head of the laboratory. And the other one, I don't think you will recognize him, I hope he's recognizing himself, Peter. Peter Herings, the second one of the right hand side. Also, we had a lot of guest lecturers. The institute, especially in the beginning, was not able to function properly without guest lectures. And again, it was just, I found some of names I remember, some I met and some were already gone before I came, more or less. Van Dam, Oorschot, Kalbermatten, De Koning on his absence, farewell party made by provided by students. And to the left hand side, one I know quite well, was Gerrit Hekstra. He was an environmentalist into the deepest of his heart. historical guests. Now, one of the most historical guests we had ever in the institute was Yasser Arafat. And I think it was 1994, 1996. I don't have the exact date, but I can find it. Jan, you'd know, because you gave me some of these pictures. I will find out. So Yasser Arafat, and of course an important visit was at that time the President General of UNESCO, Koichiro Matsura. That was the day we officially became UNESCO, a UNESCO institute, and he made also a visit in the lab. And you may recognize Professor Savenay guiding him,
in a yellow coat left to him.
Also quite some social activities we have seen. Skating. Most students, I think, can't imagine that it's possible in the Netherlands, because last few years there was no ice at all. But we had a famous skating on the Oude Delft in 1987. That is with Helga Eekhoorn in the middle, in the left-hand side, and Han Klein, just a little bit. Han is here also. You recognize yourself, Han, a little bit from your face is still visible. But also, 10 years later, we had a very severe winter in 1996. And then there was a skating party. And I still don't know if the lectures were suspended for that reason, or that we just could only do it in the lunchtime. I have no idea. But this was in 1996 on the Westfest, just in front of the Institute. Nowadays, students have an introductory day at Meijendel in Wassenaar. Till about 5 years ago, we had a two-day introductory period in Epe, as somewhere in the central part of the Netherlands. And I have just what we did here. This is a picture of 1993. I'm very pleased that Peter Kelderman is also here. I saw him. There were prizes to win, and he won with his group during an introductory session. He won a first prize. Some people were also next to Peter. The small man next to him was Father Pete. He was the Catholic priest. But I wanted to look for the word priest. I wanted to look for another word. But that's okay. Yeah. And it was the most terrible year of introductions. It was raining cats and dogs. And unfortunately, it was the first time that Nemanja Trifunovic joined the Ape party, and I can't imagine that he ever did it again. I don't know if Nemanja is here, because I've never seen a guy so terribly wet as Nemanja was in that year. All have seen the clog dancers, at least from the fresh participants in the Meijendel session. That was already, when I came in the Institute, it was a regular part of the introductory days. And I have your picture of 1993 and one of 1999, that the clog dancers, and maybe you may recognize some of the clog dancers, because they are getting older and older, but maybe still recognizable. When I retired 4 years ago, I gave also a final speech, and I was I had taken a poem of Bob Dylan at that time, as the last one, at that time not knowing that he would win the Nobel Prize for Literature this year. So it was a nice idea to repeat that again. I've adapted the text again a little bit. It's from one of his albums of Planet Waves in 1974. And this is the basic text, but let me finish this, not before I've said, I have already, for people that are interested in more old pictures, I'm giving a lunch break. Can I call it a seminar? A lunch break seminar with many more old pictures, but I will announce that it will be April or May, I think. So then, my last words of this presentation are: may your mission as IAC always be sustained. May your staff always stay committed. May your students always be dedicated, motivated. And may IAC stay forever young. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Henk, and the party comes afterwards, yeah. But that you are able also to have a little party at home,
I
contribute, yeah, to that. Yeah. And you also get a nice mug, and all retired colleagues will get it after the meeting. This is for the 60th anniversary, and really take care, because it's become a collector's item, probably. Our original name and logo is on that, and I think this is also something I'd like to give to you. You will get it after the meeting. Thank you very
Thank
much.
You. Thank you, Fred.
And thank you very much for being here. Now we invite for drinks downstairs, if I'm right. And before I do it, I would like to say a special welcome to our colleague from Nebraska. And because I think this is a good opportunity, Dean, to welcome you. This is also one important link of the Institute cooperating with the University of Nebraska. Thank you very much for your commitment and your dedication to the Institute. And now I invite all of you downstairs for drinks. Thank you very much.